Welcome to the Visser Podcast. I'm your host, Dr. Richard Visser. I'm a former Minister of Health and Sports with a PhD in Medical Sciences. I'm a published researcher, and a long time ago, I started my career as a doctor of chiropractic. Together, I want to explore wellness. I want to explore longevity to get you to the best health you've ever known. So join me on this podcast. All right, welcome to episode number 27, the need for speed. We're gonna obliterate visceral fat. You know how we're gonna do it? We're gonna do it with sprints, and we're gonna do it with some nutrition. But before that, we have to go and warm up sprinting style, all right? Very different. But the sprints, as you're gonna see on the MRI, you're gonna see it on the research I have, basically wipes out any aerobic exercise you're doing. So forget about aerobics, forget about running 50 miles a week, forget about it. You wanna get this, you wanna get the most dangerous fat out of your body, start sprinting twice a week, three times a week. This is the protocol. 30 seconds, full throttle. And we're gonna show you what that means. 3 minutes rest, get your heart rate back down. Do it again, 4, 5, 6 times, depending how good you are. All right, we're gonna start, and we're gonna start specifically with a couple things. One, we're gonna jog for 5 minutes. Then we're gonna do dynamic stretches because we need to do dynamic stretches. Static stretches will lower your performance, all right? So no static stretching here. Dynamic stretching, specifically for sprinting. And then we're gonna do mini sprints, okay? So the first stretch we're gonna be doing is for the ankles, calves, the whole bottom area of your foot, the ankle, all right? Crotch walks, all right? So you're gonna go down. If you need something to hold on to a railing, okay? We're gonna do these, boom, 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 boom. See how I'm getting down? Getting down, I'm really stretching my ankles, getting that grip, okay? We're doing this. That's the first one we're doing. Next one we're gonna be doing is gonna be the kickbacks, okay? This is specifically for sprinting, right? Hands and knees, okay? Get this leg back here, boom. Get it back, get it back. This is for the hip, this is for your quads, this is for really a kickback, this is specifically for sprinting. We're gonna do both sides, of course, boom, boom. So you can bring it down straight, up, over, bring even your head up. If you can't, boom, 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 right? That's your second. Third, you're gonna do hamstring stretches. Okay, and that's, again, dynamic. Just walk forward, lean over, boom. Again, lean over. And you're also doing your glutes here. So you're stretching your glutes, stretching your hamstrings. We want to get these guys stretched, all right? And initially, told you the way we start out is just walking and then jogging. And I want you to jog like 5 minutes. So your jogging is gonna look, this is before the active stretching or the dynamic stretching. Your jog's gonna be look chest up, gaze up on the ball of your foot. So kind of like you're sprinting. That's how I want you to warm up. 5 minutes of that before we start this active stretching. All right, next we're gonna have hands up lunges. Really open up the rib cage for your sprinting because you're gonna need the breath, right? So I'm gonna go boom, 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 boom. These are all specific dynamic stretches for sprinting. Okay, the next one we're gonna be doing, shoulders. So we also know with sprinting, this is gonna be one of the things we're using. So we gotta release that. So what I want you to do is these, get that shoulder open. Get it open. You can see the back. All right. Get the shoulders released. Rotator cuff released. Also in the back, you want to get your back muscles released. All right. Get that open. Get that released. So we're almost done with our dynamic stretches. The glutes we already did. So we're going to do some incremental sprints, and I'm going to start with just three movements here. First one is really the arm movement. So it's like you're sprinting, but you're standing still. I want this motion, which is going to be your arm motion in the sprints, quick, to get activated. All right, turn to the other side. Same thing, activated, and going. And so all these things, do 8 times, do 10 until you really feel warmed up. Next, we're going to do some speed work, okay? Striking the ground. So what I want you doing, I want you to strike the ground behind you, okay? So like this, because I want you to get used to your feet landing behind your hips. When we're sprinting, our feet land behind our hips to push. We're not doing like a jog where we're actually, or on a treadmill, where we're actually landing forward and then pulling the floor. We are actually landing behind our hips and just pushing. All right, just boom, push. So we're gonna go over that. Those are the kind of the speed drills I want you to do. And then, now that we're activated, we're gonna go do a sprint. Okay, but before that, my son Kai is gonna do a warm-up. He's got his own style of warm-up, so I want you guys to see that. Here we go. All right, so my son Kai right now is gonna show us how to warm up. All right, Kai. Oh, really, dude? Really? That's what you're gonna do to me? All right, cut that. Okay, so with sprinting, besides what I'm gonna show you medically, the benefits, increased metabolism, increased EPOC, which is the oxygen consumption, afterwards, release of adrenaline and HGH, build muscle, boost testosterone. I mean, you know, the list goes on. We got trigger muscle hypertrophy, promotes muscle recovery, improve cardiovascular health even. It's I'm looking for my special stuff to sprint here. Hold on a second. So yeah, it's, you know, mental toughness, lung capacity. I mean, we're talking improved speed and agility and the most effective way to reduce dangerous visceral fat. Found them. Like when you sprint, you know, like the superstars, you need something to bang. You know what I'm saying? To do the boom, boom. So we're gonna do that right here. All right, you ready? All right, let's do this. Boom, baby. Let's sprint. All right, come on. Next, I'm going to show you an MRI of a guy. He's a patient of Dr. O'Hara's. He was running consistently for years, 50 miles a week, 10 miles a day, distance, right? Stop doing that. He got to see his visceral fat and then put him on sprinting. So completely stop the distance work, put him on sprinting. Here you're going to see the difference in the visceral fat, all right? It's the pink colored one on the inside. So around his heart, around his organs, in his muscles, in his everything. All right, this is the deadly fat. Look what happens. Secondly, what I want you to do is look at the following MRIs that we're gonna show you are based on this. Processed carbs, highly processed foods. You need to cut them out of your diet. Starches, cut them out of your diet. The high glycemic index foods, cut them out. They're gonna cause visceral fat accumulation. The other thing, alcohol, right? So if you're consuming alcohol every day, and not like half a glass of wine, but more than that, you're gonna have to cut it, all right? Leave it for the weekend, whatever. Pick your day, pick your off days when you're doing alcohol, but watch it with that. All right, because it's gonna go straight to your liver. The other things that may play a role, stress. All right, it's gonna activate cortisol, which is gonna create some visceral fat, and lack of sleep. You need to get your 7 hours. You know, get your Oura Ring if you need to. I'm not getting sponsored by them, but that's what I use, because Sleeping is important. I want to track it. I want to see how good I do, right? So if I'm ready. So one more caveat. Now, we talked about it in episode 1, 2, and 3, microbiome. Make sure it's optimized. If you've been through anabiotic cycle, make sure you're doing fermented foods. Make sure you're, you know, doing a pre-probiotic to get your microbiome back to where it needs to be, because that could play a role, all right? Plays a role in digestion, plays a role in mood, as you know, plays a role in a lot of things, all right? If you want to see how many things, go back to episode 1, 2, and 3. So that's it, all right? We're here in this gym brief to get you jacked. And it doesn't matter what age. I'm 58. I'm going to be sprinting when I'm 68, 78, all right? So don't give me the age excuse. Don't give me the gender excuse. Works for everyone. So I need you out there twice a week minimum, sprinting 30 seconds, 20, 30 seconds, 4, 5 times, all right? With a 3-minute stop. Subscribe, ring the bell notification, join me on this journey, and I promise you, you're going to be the healthiest you've ever been. Let's keep going.